Morning peeps, good morning everyone, how's everyone doing? Hopefully you guys are all doing well. Don't forget, hit that subscribe button. If you guys are new to the channel, don't forget as well to like and share the vid. We are back people, back on the green chair, and it's good to be back as well. I've only been gone like 4 or 5 days, but as you guys know, a lot can happen in one day in this crazy sport that we love. So I'm guessing there's going to be a lot to unpack in the next sort of 20, 25 minutes or so in this video. A lot surrounding Anthony Joshua and that Instagram post. We'll get to that in a minute. But let's just jump straight in because, as I say, we do have a lot of catching up to do. So many fights on the weekend. I don't know if we're going to cover them, but look, if they pop up on the story, we'll talk about them. Joe Joyce versus Zhili Zhang this weekend. I wasn't thinking about a live, but we're going to do a live. We're going to do a live watch along. We haven't done one for a while. Denzel Bentley's on that card. Michaela Meyer's on that card. She fights Christina Lindahl too. I spoke to Michaela Meyer actually a couple of days ago. I'll tell you about that in a minute. So yeah, we're going to do a live this Saturday. We're going to get going at, you know, Frank's shows go on and on and on, don't they? But we'll get going at 8 o'clock this Saturday. We might also do a live on Friday, just a catch up live. We haven't done a live for ages. So yeah, this Friday, 8 p.m. we'll do a live previewing the fight on the weekend, and we'll do a live watch along this Saturday. So put those two in your diary. All right, what we got to talk about? Katie Taylor loves training in the middle of nowhere to escape the chaos and madness. Yeah, Katie Taylor versus Chantel Cameron. What are we, 5.5 weeks away from that one? Looking forward to it. Looking forward to it. Can't wait to see what the crowd's going to be like in Ireland. A lot of people keep telling me that it's going to be crazy. Like, it's going to be louder than MSG. And I'm like, impossible. I'm like, impossible. It's not going to be. But, you know, people said, Adi, you're going to be proven wrong. So, look, I hope I am, because MSG was insane. Insane. And the reason I say I don't think it's going to be as loud is because MSG, it was two fan bases going against each other. Like, just trying to out scream and out shout each other. Puerto Ricans on one side, the Irish on the other. This is just going to be Irish. Do you know what I mean? And I prefer those rival crowds. Michael Conlon versus Lee Wood. Do you know what I mean? That kind of crowd. Incredible. But look, we'll see. Hopefully, I'm proven wrong. Amir Khan considers working with UCAD anti-doping agencies to educate fighters on drug contamination. Yeah, he's doing the rounds. He's doing the rounds. I don't know what to believe. In fact, I do know what I believe, but I'm not even going to air it because you guys know what I think. Hearn doesn't like Francis Ngannou's chances against any top-rated heavyweight. What's going on with Ngannou? Like, I do wonder if he might regret turning the UFC's deal down. I mean, sometimes you just got to walk away. Regardless of the money, you've got to walk away. You've got to keep your own pride in check. But maybe his ego got the better of him, thinking there's going to be bigger money on the table in boxing. And I mean, I guess it links to the AJ conversation we're going to have in a minute, but all of a sudden we're not hearing about Ngannou versus Fury, Ngannou versus Wilder, Ngannou versus AJ. Those are the only ones he makes big money in. Now we're hearing Ngannou having conversations with BKFC. Do you know what I mean? Like, I don't know if Ngannou makes enough money or the money he wants fighting a Dillian White or Chisora. I'm sure he would have made more money fighting John Jones, but then he's tied into a ridiculous contract. I don't know. Zhili Zhang, Joe Joyce hasn't fought anyone like me. I have power to hurt him. I agree with both of those statements, maybe. I think Zhang might be Joe Joyce's best opponent. I mean, obviously, look, what's there? Bryan Jennings, Carlos Takam, Daniel Dubois. Yeah, you might put Zhang above them, you know, or at least on the same footing as them. But I put Zhang above them. Zhang's coming off a win against Hergovic. I know what you guys are going to say. The record books say it wasn't, but it was. I was there. I saw him beat Hergovic. And he certainly has the power to hurt him. Look, it's going to be an exciting fight for 5 or 6 rounds. And it wouldn't surprise me if Joe Joyce just gets old in the ring. One of these days. I don't know if it's going to be Saturday. I don't know. But again, you guys watch these fights. They're exciting. Don't get me wrong. Look, exciting. And the engine, juggernaut. I get all those things. But my God, does he take a lot of punishment. And some, or it might be the guy that surprised you that just knocks him out or knocks him down. It might just happen because you can't keep taking that kind of punishment. And Zhang, you guys have seen the heads to head. It's a big boy as well. Big boy that can crack. So yeah. All right, let's just stick with the heavyweights. Anthony Joshua put out a post. Obviously, I'm a bit late to the party here because, as you guys know, I've been in Ghana. But AJ put a post out on his Instagram. I can't remember exactly what it was, but basically said he's fighting in December now. Bear in mind, this is an AJ that 3 days prior to that post put out a post saying, see you guys in 12 weeks, which is the summer. So I was like, yes, good. You know, we've sat down, AJ, a few times. You promised me you're fighting 3 times this year. All of a sudden, that 3 is now turned into 2. That's a big problem for me, just because, well, there's a few reasons. Number one, you said 3. I'm just going to go on what you said to me. Number two, I feel like you need more training camps and fight training camps with Derek James. And there's training camps where you're just there, you're ticking over and you're going through things, but there's a different mindset shift when you know there's a fight approaching as opposed to just ticking over. So I feel like you need more work with Derek James. Number three, what is in December? Like, what is the reason we've all of a sudden scratched out August date or July date and now going straight to December? And this is where now rumors have started. People have reached out to me like, I know anything, I know nothing. Trust me, I started reaching out to people and I got nothing back. What I have heard, and this is just pure speculation, is of some super tournament that the Saudis are putting together of Usyk versus Wilder, Fury versus Joyce, almost this semi-final tournament. Big, big money. Now, whether or not I believe that, I think there's a bit of belief in that. Like, if belief was it's going to happen, that's 100%, I'm more 60%. Like, that could be truthful. But I still don't understand, even if that is the case, even if the Saudis have said, okay, we're going to do this tournament in December and we want you 4 in it, by the way, which would be insane, crazy. Why can't AJ still have a knockabout in the summer? Now, honestly, I feel like AJ can get away with fighting a Tom Schwartz in the summer. Or a Tom Schwartz-like. I'm serious, by the way. I think people watch his performance against Franklin and like, okay, maybe he needs one more like that. And so I'm not, I just said Tom Schwartz because of Fury. Doesn't have to be a Tom Schwartz, but someone like that. Someone in that top 30. Why can't AJ still have a knock around with someone like that? Why can't he just get some rounds in? Or is that too risky? I don't think it is. But look, that's what's happening right now. So AJ will be back in December. And again, for him to sit out the next, 6 months, 7 months, surely December has to be fucking enormous. But I don't know why these fighters keep rolling the dice like this. I don't know why you, anything can happen between now and December. Anything. Like, just fight. If you're fit to fight, fight. I honestly don't get it. So, look, I'm a bit like you guys. I'm not happy with the news. Again, I'm wanting to see AJ out again very, very soon. One thing that I've said about AJ, one big critique of AJ is that he's just not active enough. Said that about him. So it's not AJ. It's all these, a lot of the top fighters just not active enough. Like, I was watching Israel Adesanya win the UFC middleweight title back on the weekend. Active. Go and look at this guy's giving you 3 fights a year. Active. Now, other guys, it's like 1 fight. 2, if you're very lucky. 3, forget it. Forget it. You ain't getting 3 out of these guys. I mean, not many top fighters fight 3 times a year. Who? Bam Rodriguez. That's it. Can't think of anyone else. Can't think of anyone else. So, yeah, disappointing. There has been some other stuff said about AJ in the last couple of days. People have reached out to me. Addy, what do you know about AJ and this failed drug test? I'm like, what are you talking about? Don't jump to rumors and conclusions that you know nothing about. Like, where are you getting this from? I'm all for talking about these things, guys. You know, I don't avoid it. Amir Khan, Conor Ben, although very difficult subjects, I don't avoid it. I'm not just going to make something up from thin air and discuss it. So for those of you that are reaching out to me saying, Addy, talk about it, what's there to talk about? There's nothing to talk about. If there's something to talk about, trust me, I'll talk about it. Even that. AJ, I get it. It's a tough one, but I will talk about it. Nothing to talk about. So stop this speculation of rubbish, please. Please. All right, Ryan Garcia on Javonte Davis. If he gets knocked down, let's see how he reacts. Woo, that'll be crazy. Can't wait to go to this fight. So I fly out to New Orleans on Tuesday for the Misfit stuff. I am there until Friday. Straight after the fight on Friday, I fly to Vegas for this fight. So I'm doing like a pre-show. I'm doing the pre-show for Ryan versus Tank. And I'm hearing that you can't get a ticket, love nor money for it. Like the amount of A-list celebs that are going to be there. It's going to be like one of those old school fights that I used to watch years ago where you just look around and you wait up till 4 a.m. and you just look around the ring and it's just literally everyone who's everyone is going to be there. I think this is this kind of fight. So look, really looking forward to it. I've said Tank from the beginning, so I'm going to stick with him, but I say that with no clear view on who's going to win. I think it's going to be close, really, really close. KSI's promoter, who's this? Is this Mams Taylor? Believes Tommy Fury deal can happen after meeting Father John. Okay, next. Eddie Hearn on Mutarbiev Smith. We expect a deal to get done. Would love to do the fight in Liverpool. It looks like they're struggling. Not struggling, but it looks like... Well, actually, that is the word. Struggling to get Bivol a real big name to fight next. Like, obviously, look, the key was Boatsy. Boatsy was the one, right? Scrap all this. Just go Bivol Mutarbiev now, then. Like, it's open. Like, the floor's open. Go right now. Bivol Mutarbiev. None of the governing bodies will mind. It's an undisputed fight. Everyone eats a little bit of money. I don't understand. I like Mutarbiev Smith. But I want Mutarbiev Bivol. If that can be made, make that. I'm not... Look, Mutarbiev Smith's a great fight, don't get me wrong. But Mutarbiev Bivol's... Like, who doesn't want to see an undisputed? Before, I thought, okay, the reason we might not get it is because Bivol's trying to go Canelo, but we know Canelo's got Ryder, and Bivol's trying to go Boatsy, and Boatsy's obviously gone to Sky. It doesn't look like that's going to happen yet anytime soon. So what are we waiting for? Well, Josh Taylor... Teofimo Lopez didn't show up. He's got no backside. Can't hide much longer. Disappointed. For Josh to fly out to the States. I mean, it's funny, though. Everyone's like, Josh can't get into the States. Well, clearly he can. For Josh to fly out to the States and Teofimo not to be there. Slightly disappointing. I have to admit, slightly disappointing. I like that fight a lot, you know. I do. I really do. It's a big fight. They see what they were saying, though. I don't know if you guys have seen their little back and forth. It wasn't even a back and forth. Quite respectful of each other, actually. But they were saying, like, why is this in the Hulu Theater? Why is it not in Big MSG? What's the capacity of the Hulu Theater? $5,600. Come on, man. They can do that, surely. Why is this fight even happening in the States, then? Why is it not happening over here? Like, this over here is the AO Arena, surely. This is the Manchester Arena, surely. Wembley Arena, surely. 5,600. God. Joshua Boatsy aims to be dominant, make a statement against Pavel Estepian. Remember, this is the guy that Callum Smith was supposed to fight a month ago. Let's see what Boatsy can do, man. I'm excited to see this next stage of Boatsy. Hopefully it's a good one. Clarissa Shields, I wanted a rematch with Gabrielle's ever since our first fight. Yeah, I just saw this one when I was out there, that Clarissa Shields will be fighting on DAZN in her next fight against Gabrielle's, who's the current light heavyweight champion, I believe. This fight's going to be at middleweight, so I don't know, you know, don't know what that would do to Gabrielle's coming down, but Shields just got to stay busy. This is the problem for Shields, though, isn't it? For as good as she is, she's in a weight division where there isn't much else. I mean, this is why Tasha Jonas has moved up, because you can go up and there's when you compare it to, like, again, when I was speaking to Michaela Meyer, who's fighting this weekend at 135 pounds, in around that weight class of 130 to 147, there's a lot of work, a lot of good work, some good fights to be made. Shields is in a position where I know she said she can make with 154, but that's not going to be easy. So there's no one apart from, really, unless there's girls coming through, apart from the rematch with Savannah. Like this Gabrielle's fight, think of how big Savannah was, the heat between those two. This ain't going to do anything like that. And I maybe shouldn't be saying it because it's on DAZN, but it's true. It's not. It's not, is it? Like, and this is why I found it quite funny when Clarissa was like, you need to come to America, Savannah. And I'm like, you go where the money is. You guys sold out the O2 Arena. Go where the money is. It'd be interesting to see what kind of numbers Clarissa can do. Like, how big is her superstardom? I think she needs a dance partner, but let's see. Let's see if she can do it all herself. I don't know. Shakur Stevenson, ref should have kept it going. I wanted to put Yoshino down, finish him. Watched his fight. I watched it in Ghana. And I actually tweeted that Shakur's going to win belts at 135, 140, and 147. And someone was like, ain't that easy? Obviously, ain't that easy. I just think he's going to do it because I think he's that special. Obviously, I know that at 135, there's talent there. At 140, there's talent there. I get it. 147, Ennis will be there. I get all these things. But that's not, it's not like, I don't think Ennis is going to be undisputed. I'm going to say he will win a belt in all of those divisions. And look, he could beat Ennis when it's time for him to fight Ennis in a couple of years' time. He could do it. I just think that when I watch Shakur Stevenson, as opposed to all those other guys at 135, 140, 147, obviously I'm not talking Terence Crawford and Spence here, by the way. He just looks special. It's the eye thing. Again, might happen, might not happen. But I think when it's all said and done, this kid's going to be a four-weight world champion. I really do. I really do. And then, because he's actually quite tall as well. When you see the photos of him next to Terence Crawford, he's not small. He doesn't look smaller than Terence. I just think he's special. All right, anything else? Little bits. Bits here about Javonte. Bits here about Frank Sanchez. Little bits and bobs. But we are done. It's been a long day. We just only got back a couple of days ago. But look, live on Friday, live watch along on Saturday. Peace and love.